Welcome to 20 Questions with the NRF Foundation. I'm Athina Kanioura, PepsiCo's Chief Strategy and Transformation Officer. And I couldn't be more excited and humbled to be recognized on the list of people shaping retail's future for 2025. I look forward to sharing an inside look into my career and how we are working to transform the world of retail at PepsiCo. But first, let me tell you a little bit about PepsiCo. PepsiCo is a global leader in convenient foods and beverages, and our products are enjoyed by consumers more than 1 billion times a day across over 200 countries and territories in the world. Through our ongoing end-to-end strategy and transformation, we are revolutionizing how we engage, connect, and meet the demands of our consumers globally, while giving our people and our partners the tools and the capabilities that are needed to future-proof their business and thrive at the shelf. I'm very excited to share more about our journey. So with that, let's jump into 20 questions. What was your first job? Well, my first job was actually in academia. So while I was growing up, I always wanted to teach and learn and give back to the communities. So I got the chance while I was doing my PhD in the UK to teach applied mathematics, applied statistics. That was my first love while growing up. And still till this day, I'm teaching in Imperial College London. How did you get to the role you are currently in? So while I was having my career as a professor, I saw that I loved STEM a lot. In parallel, kind of I pivoted to consulting, where I had different roles from being a chief data scientist to a chief analytics officer, and ultimately a chief digital officer. That actually paved the way on me getting exposure to various industries, retail and consumer goods being the most dominant industry where I spent the quality of my time in consulting. And of course, in 2020, I was given the amazing opportunity to lead the newly established function, the Global Strategy and Transformation Organization, under our current chairman and CEO. And that has allowed me and has given me the chance to first of all implement a lot of the strategies and practices that I've learned both in academia and in consulting now to one of the most renowned companies in the world, but also help shape the future of how brands and experiences in a company like ours can be transformed with the power of technology, the power of digital, the power of process standardization end-to-end. So currently, I'm leading an organization that spans from corporate strategy and category strategy to business transformation, process excellence and process delivery, big iconic programs like direct-to-consumer, integrated business planning and cost transformation, and of course, digital technology and service delivery. Why is retail the industry you picked for the career? It was always very enticing to see what triggers the consumer, what drives consumer choices, and how everything that you see on your table can move from source to table, and how the industry is really transforming the way people's lives are being shaped. So looking back, it has always been incredible how products like ours, products that you see on the shelf, that are being enjoyed by billions of consumers, are being designed, thought of, innovated, created, are being made, and then are moving into the end point of sale and ultimately land to the household and the consumer himself. So by responsibly integrating these advancements, what we are trying to become for our consumers and for our associates and our partners, we try to become much more innovative, agile, and thoughtful about how those experiences and the products that we create come together under a very sophisticated, but also a very simplified experience for the end user. What career advice would you give to your younger self? Be bold, you know, take calculated risks, use learning as a platform to evolve and develop, both as a professional, but also as a person. And especially in the world that we live in, trusting in your abilities, finding ways to make your ideas heard, and having always a seat on the table cannot be taken for granted. You have to persevere, you have to be assertive. Career is about taking calculated risks. That's what I've done historically. That's what has made me be the person that I am. And especially growing up in a very male-dominated field where females in STEM were more the outlier than the norm, it has taught me to always ask for what I want, but be extremely well prepared and thoughtful about everything I do influences another set of women that are around me. So again, the best piece of advice I would give myself is always put yourself in the shoes of everyone who is looking up to you and keep loyal to your values and what you believe in. Tell us about an experience you've had that defines retail for you. What I love about retail is how it has been able to redefine what it means to be part of this industry. When you historically look back at retail, you were thinking, you know, brick and mortar or old school or lack of innovation, much more of a push than a pull. And suddenly, retail is synonymous to innovation. Retail is synonymous to digitalization. Retail is synonymous to next-gen AI. The way this industry has transformed by embracing the wave of technology disruption that has come our way and how it has allowed now, especially for consumers and society, to be always everywhere, to have every single product and experience that we as consumers need at any given point in time, in our house, in our office, everywhere we are, it's the most amazing experience and breakthrough innovation that this industry has been able to achieve in all the, you know, decades that retail, especially in this country, has been operating. So I feel the best is yet to come. If I were to think of how the retailer landscape is being shaped by the influence of channels like social commerce and the digitalization of every single experience, and now how Gen AI will disrupt also the way we ingest and use those experiences, I'm extremely hopeful about elevation of everything that retail has to do and moving into adjacent spaces as well. Tell us about a great manager you had and how they impacted your career. I have to say I have been extremely fortunate throughout the past 20, 25 years to have amazing mentors. Mentors who have really defined who I am, who have given me great advices on how I should elevate myself as a leader in the organizations that I have been. And on top of that, female trailblazers who have been the embodiment of what it meant to be and lead fearlessly in the organizations that they were leading. Having the right level of mentorship and fostering that that environment is always critical for success. What three skills are key to succeeding in retail? First, always be human-centric. We talk about human centricity, we talk about putting people at the center. This is obviously what we do as PepsiCo. I mean, everything we design from experiences to products has consumers at the heart of the thinking, has people at the heart of the experience. But it's the collective job of the retail industry to think of what are those pivotal moments in the lives of consumers, in the lives of the households that we serve, that are critical as an industry to influence, to serve, to elevate, and that's a big responsibility. The second key success factor is adaptability. We live in an era where everything is real time, everything is agile, things keep changing, and therefore being and having the ability to adapt, to be resilient, and ensure that in an ever-evolving environment, you are able to course correct and adjust is a key success criteria. And lastly, but equally importantly, you have to be data and insights driven. We've always believed in PepsiCo and with our partners that data is a competitive advantage. Understanding what are the future trends that influence consumer behavior is important for the not just the success of any corporation, but it is important for the viability of the enterprise that we and the industry that we operate. So how do you innovate? How do you create meaningful brand experiences? How do you ensure that your products are always everywhere is cannot be done, cannot be served without having data and insights first in your strategy. What do you do to stand out? Having my professional career starting from academia has made me always be extremely curious. So one thing that I put as a always as a top priority is to keep on learning, understanding what is out there, trying to learn about the newest trends, going deeper in areas that are critical for my company or even kind of my personal development. So learning as a platform for me to develop has always been a number one priority. And the second most important thing is always challenge myself to always deliver the best of experiences for my associates, for my peers, for my teams, and give everyone the opportunity through this platform of sharing and collaborating to grow and succeed collectively. What is the biggest risk you have taken in your career? I think I have taken a lot of risks in my career. If I were to think that I've always wanted to be and stay in academia, and I went from academia to consulting, and obviously now in a great industry like our industry. But I would say probably the biggest risk throughout that is I've traveled everywhere in the world. I've lived everywhere in the world. I mean, Athens, Singapore, London, Paris, United States, and I think I've visited more than 100 countries along the journey. So what has been the underlying theme to take that risk and opportunity and make it a success factor is having always a global mindset. So I come from a small country, but I consider myself a global citizen because living and experiencing how people interact with each other, how people create experiences in all the different parts of the world, and then trying to adjust to the reality and the expectations of that society has probably been the biggest learning in my career. And through this experience, I have made a lot of friends in every corner of the world, which I truly cherish. What qualities do you look for in your employees? The two most important qualities is curiosity and hard work. Without curiosity, you cannot push yourself to go to the next level. Take the leap of faith to the unknown. Try to understand what is out there and experiment and maybe fail, but try again and stand up and fail again and then try again. Eventually, you succeed. So being curious about the world, the opportunities, the people around you is a very big trait that I look into my teams. And the second is definitely hard work. We talk a lot about talent, but talent on its own, if you don't develop it with hard work, remains raw talent, right? I always love to take people that some, you know, others consider, you know, they're mediocre, you know, they're good enough, and make them exceptional and develop them. Why? Because they have this, you know, fire in them to want to prove that they can be better. They want to work hard to make themselves better. So that's the culture that we have within our S&T organization, our strategy and transformation team, is we are curious, we are passionate, and we are hard workers. What is your leadership philosophy? Look, I truly believe that the whole is always greater than the sum of its parts. even if I were to look at, how PepsiCo operates and the microcosmos of my organization, we are a very flat pyramid. We like we democratize decision making. We like people to contribute to the ideas. We don't believe that you can accomplish excellence by doing things individually. And we have pivoted the company from the hero syndrome to the adopter syndrome, from the individual success to the collective success. And that is what makes an organization great. How can you create an inclusive environment for everyone to thrive, for diversity to be at the heart of the decision process, and no matter what the background, the culture, the geography, everyone feels at home? What innovations are you most proud of? Definitely, I would say in the area of R&D and product development, where we have been using AI to be able to cut the innovation cycle significantly down to 6-8 weeks as we are launching new products, new flavors, even for breakthrough innovation by using digital twins to simulate what the different product attributes could look like. In the area of supply chain, where in domains like manufacturing, we are using industrial IoT platforms and smart manufacturing to increase true efficiency and drive immense productivity, but also safety for our associates in the facilities. As I'm looking at our commercial capabilities, perfect execution and perfect order is always at the heart of what we are trying to do because we want to drive service excellence as part of our effort. So these are just three examples of capabilities that I'm super proud of, that by leveraging great technology, by leveraging the know-how and the amazing experience of our frontline associates, and also very standardized processes and playbooks, we have been able to achieve amazing results in the organization. How do you turn off work and how do you encourage your team to find work-life balance? With the years, I have got better at it, especially since I have two beautiful boys, 14 and 11, who, push me to be out there with them, whether it's in sports or there are other activities that we do. So the one thing that we as a family unplug is playing tennis together. This is a big family sport for us. Although I cannot keep up with my husband and the boys when it comes to all the sports activities and the chaos that comes with that, the fact that we have fine moments that we as a family hit the tennis courts in the evenings, or I go and look at my sons playing competitive tennis over the weekends, is the way for me to recharge and stay grounded on what matters the most, and this is family. What is one job most people are surprised to find out is part of retail? As I have said, retail has evolved a lot. I mean, it moved from being the traditional brick and mortar store to being, an always-on experience in any type of platform, whether it's an B2B platform, a D2C platform, social commerce, so on and so forth. So you can interact, you can exchange, you can create retail experiences everywhere. And sometimes people think retail experiences are provided by only the big retailers. The fact now we have platforms that consumers can go and sell and buy and auction and exchange through actual currency and digital currency, through Bitcoin or other digital assets, it suggests how the retail industry has evolved to being like a big auction house, right? That you can interact at any given point in time through the power of immersive experiences. And I believe the future of retail, in every facet of retail, whether it's fashion or grocery or general merchandising, will keep on evolving even more. Why? Because the consumers dictate that, right? And we have a responsibility as players in this industry to make sure that the traditional view of the industry outside keeps on transforming. Why? Because consumers expect more and more modernization. What is something unexpected about your career in retail? I believe everything has an applied application. So by starting my career in academia and then obviously spending 15 years in consulting, there are a lot of common themes that surface by going back into the history and reading many of the papers and the literature, but also looking at themes across industry. You know, sometimes in our industry we believe we are too unique. Well, actually we are not, right? I find a lot of common references points if you look at industries like the energy or how the communications industry has evolved, or even sometimes in the retail banking industry. So the one advice I always kind of give my colleagues is we need to be humble because we believe we have all the answers for everything where other industries have solved the specific problem. So how can we learn from the experiences of others? How we can leverage the learnings of the past so we cannot repeat the same mistakes? Because the last thing we want is for this industry to be obsolete. So that is something that I believe kind of surprises people when they meet me, because I try to invoke those experiences to be able to find solutions in the most difficult problems of the industry. What is the most rewarding part of your job? Oh, by far, is when we finally crack it, right? So in the moments where I am with the team and we do problem solving and we say, so how do we do that? How do we scale that? How do we solve this problem? And, you know, then that moment comes and we found the solution and we find the way to industrialize. That's the most rewarding moment for me and for the team. So having those, I call them the moments that delight the team, is what gives me the most satisfaction. What is one misconception about retail that you would love to debunk for everyone? So one of the biggest misconceptions is that retail is simply about selling products to consumers. And I think it's very hard sometimes for people to understand that we are talking about a very complex but a very interconnected value chain. So even if you think of companies like us, we, you know, source and grow everything from farming to growing the product, moving the product, right? And delivering and selling those products in every single touch point. So think of your favorite bag of Lay's that you can buy on the store, that you can order from any type of e-grocery, or you can get through any commerce or direct-to-consumer channel, right? Is you get it and you say, okay, so simple for me to hold Lay's on my hands. Well, it requires a lot of work to bring this wonderful packet of Lay's and have this amazing experience when you eat it. Why? Because it's an end-to-end interconnected chain from the raw ingredient to the farmer, to the production line, to our driver, to the store, to the shelf, to the table, right? So the misconception is that it's a simple value chain, right? The reality is a complex but interconnected and integrated value chain. How does your company in the retail industry overall impact people in every community and every day? At PepsiCo, our commitment is always to our communities. We have our PepsiCo Foundation, which through the programs that we have, we are always trying to serve the communities that we operate in, whether they are underprivileged communities or communities that our associates are living, and therefore it is important that we support them in any way we can. And ultimately, we do have a responsibility in the broader food system. We sit at the heart of the food system. We are one of the biggest agro-producers, potato producers in the world. And therefore, our collective responsibility to feed people is at the heart of what dictates our mission and our vision as an organization, where agriculture sits at the heart of this strategy, and our people, our associates, and our communities is the bloodline of this organization. How does the future of retail look like? The future of retail is truly reshaped by automation and technology. So fundamentally, we believe that there is no future if we as an industry don't embrace AI, digitalization, intelligent automation, and everything that we now test and pilot and experiment across the ecosystem. At PepsiCo, we are fully dedicated to harnessing these advancements, everything that can revolutionize the way we do supply chain, the way we move our products, and the way we create superior consumer experiences can only be enhanced and informed by the technology innovation. What does it mean for you to be recognized by the NRF Foundation as one of the people sparking incredible change in retail? I'm really humbled by this incredible honor. I'm very fortunate to work in this industry and amongst so many talented colleagues at PepsiCo and obviously with our partners. I consider this industry to be such a humbling industry because what we do is so close to every single consumer. We touch billions of lives of people every day. And this award is just as much theirs as it is mine. A big thank you to the NRF Foundation for truly recognizing the impact and my impact on the retail industry and allowing us as a company to play a role in advancing its future. I've truly enjoyed answering the 20 questions and sharing more about how I've built my career in retail. You can check out more insights with retail professionals, including more episodes with honorees on the list of people shaping retail's future at nrffoundation.org. I'm Athina Kanioura, Chief Strategy and Transformation Officer at PepsiCo. Thank you for watching.